I work in a variety of places in central India and then South India, and I had some field sites in Bengal. Now, landscapes can a patch of land or can be planned for a variety of uses. Where, for example, you have it has hill systems, and then it has water that come whenever it rains. The waters flow through nalas and streams, and then join some big river or go into the sea. And then you have some agriculture areas, and then you have some living areas. So it creates these mosaics. So, and these mosaics, what they do is, because they have each mosaic is different, it supports diversity of, it allows other species also to thrive in these ecosystems. Because simply because of the landscape mosaics. On the other hand, if you just look at homogeneous landscapes where you just have paddy or rice and nothing else, these landscapes only suit a certain kind of species and not the others. So what this means is only a few animals or birds can survive here. And for example, seed-eating birds can survive, and the rest can just they disappear.
Right.
I mean, these are the visible things on the ground. In India, the agriculture traditionally has been about cultivating the land. It's about raising crops. It's about feeding, breeding livestock.
Yeah.
A farmer, if you look at a traditional landscape, agricultural landscape, a farmer would have his own trees, where fooding trees, where he generates something. He has his own, a little talab or a pond, or his own well, small nalas in that. So he would have these irregular bits of and bobs built into his land, which can serve a lot of his needs. Mm. Now, keeping that land very irregular is the traditional way of doing agriculture, but that also supported a lot of other species, like sparrows or I mean, you're talking about small things, right? We're not talking about tigers and elephants. Even small things like sparrows, ants, insects, butterflies, bees. We'll come to the importance of these. I mean, we always talk about, the bigger charismatic species, but the importance of bees for a landscape is something unfathomable, because just imagine an agriculture area without bees. Bees are the basic pollinators, bees, wasps, etc., butterflies. I mean, as they move from flower to flower, they keep pollinating a lot of these, and then eventually they all blossom into whatever we eat and drink, whatever we eat and consume. If there were no bees, who would do that job? So you're already seeing a trend in India where you have these industrial farms, like on the right, in Maharashtra, in Deccan Plateau, where everything is removed. And here the core goal is to maximize profits, just to grow the same thing in huge quantities. Now, what you do is you remove these mosaics that you see on the left, and you just create these mono landscapes.
Right.
And what you do is you do everything to make it very, very compatible for that particular plant on the ground. But soon what you realize is the whole system, the most important is the soil. The soil changes its composition. It only suits the need. So whatever needs, for example, if a particular plant needs more magnesium, what you do is you start giving it more magnesium so that plant gets that. So eventually what happens is the composition of the soil is manipulated by people who are exploiting that landscape.